Hi, this is Allison Bales with Energy Vanguard, and today I want to talk to you about an important topic, and that is oversized heating and cooling systems. I've been in homes all over the country, I've looked at the sizes of systems, and sometimes have found them to be grossly oversized. Many times found them to be grossly oversized. A factor of two is not uncommon. Sometimes three times bigger than they need to be. So today I'm going to show you six reasons why that's a bad idea. And at the end of this video, I'm going to give you some hints on what you can do to get a proper size system when you next have to replace a system in your existing home or put a new system in a new home. Now, let's get into those reasons why you don't want to have an oversized heating and cooling system. Number one on the list is comfort. When you have an oversized system, it has too much capacity for the heating and cooling loads in the house, and so it's going to come on, it's going to blast you with cold air in summer for a few minutes, it's going to blast you with hot air in winter for a few minutes, then it's going to go off. The house will start heating up again in summer or cooling off again in winter, and you'll start to feel it. You will start to feel a little uncomfortable. So a properly sized system will give you better comfort in the house. Number two on the list is noise. A bigger system has a bigger blower. A bigger blower is a noisier blower. And often the duct system is not designed very well. It's not designed for the amount of airflow that it's moving. The installers often put ducts in that are too small, and small ducts mean more noise. Then there's the issue of the return duct location. If it's close to the blower, you may get a direct line from the blower into your living space where that noise is going to go straight in there. A bigger blower means more noise, remember. I had that situation in a condo I lived in. We had a return right by where we kept the TV. When the air conditioner or furnace came on, we had to turn the TV up. It was so noisy. Number three on the list is cost. Bigger systems cost more up front. You've got to pay for that extra capacity, just like when you buy a laptop with more memory, more storage, a faster computer, you're going to have to pay more for it. Same thing with a heating and cooling system. A bigger system is going to cost more. Number four on the list is dehumidification. A bigger air conditioner will have shorter run times in summer, and so it will do less dehumidification, because what happens is the water sits on the coil after condensing from the air. And when the system goes off, then that water sitting on the coil can evaporate back into the air and keep the house more humid than it should be. So a properly sized system gives you longer run times, and it will condense more moisture on that coil, let it sit there long enough to drip down into the pan and drain away, and you will feel more comfortable in the house. Number five on our list of reasons not to oversize a heating and cooling system is the space that you need for the ductwork. A bigger system has a bigger blower, moves more air, and it will need bigger ductwork. You may or may not have enough room for all the ductwork. So if you size it properly, you need smaller ductwork and everything works better. Bigger ductwork also costs more, so that feeds into the cost issue as well. And last but not least on our list of reasons not to oversize your heating and cooling system is that it is unnecessary. The reason systems end up oversized is that a lot of contractors use rules of thumb. They have a square footage rule, like 1 ton for every 500 square feet. It's just based on the size of the house and nothing else. One version of a rule of thumb based on size only is this thing called manual E. It's fake, it's not real, but in the past, some contractors have used this. You have cutouts on a piece of paper. The instructions on this particular one says stand 103 feet in front of the house, hold it up, and whichever hole the house fits better, that's the size system you need. Well, that absolutely is a terrible way to do it. Using the size of the house only, whether you do it a square foot per ton rule or this manual E thing or some other way, leaves out a lot of critical factors. For example, look at this house. There's a lot of windows on one side of the house, not so many on the others. rotating this house so that those windows go from facing north, for example, to facing west, can increase the size of the load on that house, and thus the size of the equipment that you need to heat and cool it, by 50% or even more. So using rules of thumb leaves out these critical factors, and we need to take into account all these factors. What type of windows? What's the orientation of the windows? What kind of insulation is in the house? How airtight is the house? There's a lot of factors that go into this, and that's why we have a protocol for sizing systems called Manual J. It's from the Air Conditioning Contractors of America, ACCA. And it includes all these factors that we need to consider to come up with an accurate load on the house for heating and cooling. But Manual J is not the end. Manual S is also required. And that is where you take the Manual J loads, how much heating and cooling the house needs. You factor in the type of equipment you have, what its capacities are in different conditions, and pick the equipment that will actually meet those loads the best. And we know at Energy Vanguard that this is unnecessary because we have done thousands of load calculations and equipment selection for houses all over North America, mostly in the U.S., but some in Canada and a little bit in Mexico. So we have a lot of data on this problem. And you can see from this histogram that our average cooling load is 1 ton for every 1,200 square feet. Now, a typical rule of thumb, as I mentioned earlier, is 500 square feet per ton, or 1 ton for every 500 square feet. Our average is 1 ton for every 1,200 square feet. Now, you can see here from our chart also that some of the homes that we have designed for come in at 1 ton for 2,500 square feet or more. In short, oversized systems are unnecessary because they're a result of a process that doesn't take into account what the actual needs of the house are. All right, so now you know what the 6 reasons are why I think oversizing is a bad idea. Let's talk about solutions. If you're building new construction, the best thing to do, get full HVAC design, get a professional who understands load calculations, equipment selection, duct design, grill and register sizing and placement. All that is very important to get the HVAC system working properly, and so you can be comfortable and efficient and the house will be durable and you'll have good indoor air quality. We do that at Energy Vanguard, and a lot of other companies do too, so there are places to get this done. Now, if you have an existing home, You can do a load calculation and equipment selection, the same protocol. It still works for existing homes. Sometimes the inputs are a little iffy because you don't always know what's in the walls, but there are ways of finding some things out. So that's also a possibility for existing homes. But with existing homes, before the system starts going bad, you have another opportunity. You can measure the runtime of the system on those design days when the outdoor temperature is at your design temperature in summer or your design temperature in winter time, and see how much time the system actually runs. If it's running 10 minutes per hour, you are way oversized. If it's running 30 minutes per hour, you've got a system that's about twice as big as it needs to be. So that gives you a good idea of whether you can change the size or not in existing homes. Just measure the runtime on design days. So, and I'll have more about that in the future. But now you know that there are a lot of good reasons not to have an oversized system. You want a properly designed system that's good for comfort, it's good for noise, indoor environmental quality, indoor air quality. So get the properly sized system, however you do it, and you'll be happier.